nomenclature of nomenclature of aromatic compounds. Nomenclature of aromatic compounds. See, if you have OH present here, it is phenol or hydroxybenzene. Phenol or hydroxybenzene.
So both are iupac?
Phenol is the common name, it's not iupac. Hydroxybenzene, but you should know the common name also for this. Organic chemistry will use common name only. If you have NH2 present on the ring, it is aniline, the common name. Are you facing it? Aminobenzene. I'll write down both names. CHO. It is benzaldehyde. Or benzene carbon dehyde. COOH. It is benzoic acid. Write down the name benzoic acid. Or benzene carboxylic acid. Benzoic acid or benzene carboxylic acid.
So that's
a structure.
Again,
it is benzoic acid or benzene carboxylic acid. This is the same thing when carbon containing functional group attached directly on the ring. Benzoic acid or benzene carboxylic acid.
So benzoic is the iupac type.
Benzoic acid is
then benzene carboxylic acid is also iupac.
No, we in this case both we can take. Benzoic acid we can take or benzene carbon dihydride. We have seen the rules last class. When carbon containing functional group attached to the ring, we use carboxylic acid in that case. This one is chlorobenzene. Common it's IUPAC name chlorobenzene. Or if X is attached here, it is halobenzene. Okay, we can also call it as aryl halide. Aryl halide.
Is that general or only for
common name? Aryl is actually this group, phenyl group. When benzene ring, you remove one hydrogen from this, it becomes aryl. This is aryl. This is aryl. C6H5 is also the same thing. Aryl. Okay? So alkane, if you remove one hydrogen from alkane, it becomes alkyl. If you remove one hydrogen from benzene, it is aryl. Generally, it's aryl halide. For this one, we can write aryl chloride.
So, but aryl is common.
Yeah, it's common. Aryl is common. Aryl halide, and we also call it as phenyl. That is also same thing. Phenyl. Phenyl could also write as pH.
So that's such a bad convention.
Why?
So you can always you can say like aryl amine.
No. It's not. Aryl halide is that only for halogen if it is. Haloarenes. Haloarenes. Phenyl is C6H5. Benzyl is a benzene thing, remove one hydrogen. Phenyl.
Okay.
If any alkyl group attaches on the ring, it is alkyl benzene.
So say I have a like a benzene attached to it. What would I call it? Benzene ion.
We'll do it now. Just after this. This one is OCH3. If you have, it is methoxybenzene. Right? If any alkyl group we have OR, will write as alkoxy benzene. Yes. Ether we do know, ethoxy-ethane, because OCS3 is methoxy group. CH3OCS3 is what? Methoxy-methane. ETOCS3 is ethoxy-methane, so methoxy-ethane. Ether we have done, no? Same. Okay?
So if it was the same, OCS3, but without the three double bonds, it was just cyclohexane. It would be methoxy-cyclohexane.
Yes. See, all these names we are taking benzene, right? When the ring has this functional group attached directly onto it, we take the name, we let us with benzene, right? We don't write phenyl in this case. But the ring and side chain, if you have, and the side chain contains any functional group, then this will write it as phenyl, not benzene. Okay? So, one note you write down after this. If the side chain consists of functional group, if the side chain consists of functional group, then the benzene is known as phenyl. If the side chain consists of any functional group, if the side chain consists of any functional group, then the benzene is known as phenyl. For example, if you have a ring and this OH present here. So when the side chain contains functional group, then this becomes the parent chain. Parent chain. And this becomes the subsequent. So name of this ring will write here phenyl but not benzene. So what is the name of this compound? Numbering is 1, 2, 3.
So why is it not aryl? Why is it not aryl?
Why your name is not Akshay Kumar? Good question.
This is one thing.
Benzyl is also C6H5.
Yeah, so why is it not benzyl?
Because the side chain, if it contains any functional group, then we don't write this as benzyl. We write this phenyl. This is the rule we have. Okay, so you cannot argue why my name is Gaurav, why not any other. You cannot do that. Okay, it's the rule. Okay, so name of this compound is what? Propanol. Propanol. Propanol, if you write it under the first position. But it's better to write one all. Because when you write propanol, see, actually I'll tell you one thing. When we start the numbering from the carbon atom of the functional group, like in the case of aldehyde, carboxylic acid, or you know, acid halide, okay? There you don't have to write down the position of the functional group, because it is understood that we have to start numbering from the carbon atom of the functional group. It is a rule we have. Okay? But when you write propanol, it is understood that OH is present in the first carbon. But it's always better to write the position of OH here, because when you write propanol simply, it may be possible that the position of OH is second and third carbon. But generally, when we start numbering from the carbon atom of the functional group, there we don't write the position of the functional group, because it is understood. Rules we have for that, okay? But in this case, I'll suggest you always write down the number. If you don't write, it's fine, not wrong. But better you mention it, okay? Propane 1 or. Understood this? So whenever the side chain we have any functional group, we don't write benzyl here. We write phenyl. Okay, take care, Rasdeep, right? Okay. So this
what's
one is
the order of definition of phenyl. What's the order of definition of phenyl?
Phenyl is not a functional group, it's a substituent. Now this becomes a substituent because this contains the functional group. It has the least priority. Even if you see, if the molecule is this, right? Molecule is this. A double bond we consider as a functional group. So this becomes the parent chain now. 1, 2, 3. 3 phenyl propene, propone.
Sir, they just said propene all with no number. And MCQ, they gave us the overhead positions 1, 2, 3, and all of these. Will it be 1 or all of these?
1.
So why
do
it is 1. It is understood that 1. If you do not write, it is understood as first position. Right? 2 and 3, if it is there, you have to mention.
Last preference.
If the side chain contains, see, it's not a functional. We are not considering this as a functional group. Point is, whether this we can take as a parent chain or not. This we can only take when the side chain does not contain any functional group. If it contains, don't compare this with the priority or thing around. Okay? Either you can take this as a primary chain or this as a primary chain. If this contains any functional group, this becomes a substituent. So priority order is
one. Right? Sir, if there was no double bond, just be propyl.
Then we'll write, yeah, propyl. Like for this one, if double bond is there, the name of this will be 3-phenyl. Prop1E or propene. Okay? But if double bond is not there, this becomes the parent chain. For example, this one is see. Right, in this case it is propyl benzene. So we are using benzene here. And here we are using
In
the priority order, NO2 comes before any halogen. This also you must remember. NO2 comes before this halogen. So it is the first one. So 2, 3, and 4. What is the name of the What is NH2 and this ring?
Aniline.
So one thing is what we can write N-ethyl aniline. That also we can write. Or we can also write N-ethyl aminobenzene. Aminobenzene, we don't write because amino is the prefix of this. N-ethyl benzenamine or N-ethyl aniline. Okay. See, in this one, this example we have done. One thing I tell you here. NO2 BrNCl, right? In some book they have given this thing that the priority of NO2 is more than that of halogen atom, right? In some book they have taken same priority of all these. Okay, so in that case, what you have to do, the numbering will be done in such a way. so that you'll get lowest sum of the locates. Right. That is why you see this example.
She called everyone. No one is listening.
We have NO2 here.
She called everyone.
See, in this one also, the priority order is this given in the sum book, but NO2, BR and CL, they have almost same priority. It is not dominant.
No,
like,
what do you mean by sum book? It's like given by IUPAC, right?
No, no, it's like I said, no, sulfonic acid and carboxylic acid. Right, there is a confusion of priority order. I'm talking about priority order. It's not about the name. In the book, it is according to IUPAC only. But some book, it is followed sum of locates, lowest sum of locates. In some book, they have taken NO2 is dominates over alkyl groups. What I follow, I'm telling you, you have to follow the lowest sum of locates. I'm telling you this because you don't get confused if you see this in the book also. Okay, that's why I'm giving you all the information here. The better way is to follow lowest sum of locates rule. Okay, like in this one you see, we start numbering from this carbon atom, NO2. Because any other carbon atom if you take, the sum of locates will be more. What is sum of locates here? 1 plus 2 plus 4, that is 7. If you start from here, you'll get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 plus 3 plus 6, that is 10. Right? If you start from here, then what you get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 plus 4 plus 1, again 10. So this numbering gives you the lowest sum of locates, and that's why we are following this. So according to this, if you follow here, we have to start numbering from what? This carbon atom. Then only you'll get the lowest sum of locates too. This is lowest sum of locates. So 1 is this, 2 is this, 3 is this, 4, 5 and 6. Sum of locates is 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 7. Right? Any other numbering you'll do, you'll get more than 7 as the sum of locates. Right? So this, the name of this one will be 4-bromo, 1-chloro, 2-nitro, benzene. So always we'll follow this one, we won't follow this order over here. Right? Sum of locates will follow in this. Understood?
So, see, what are the groups have same?
NO2 we have X, halogen atom we have N, hydroxyl. Only these two will get. It is N-ethyl aniline or N-ethyl benzenamide.